is Ulrika Hedlund. I'm the founder of Business Productivity and Storials. A couple of months ago, I attended the Udemy Live conference in San Francisco, and I did a comparison of taking handwritten notes on an iPad Pro versus a Surface Book. Now, thank you to all of you who have watched the video, who have liked it, and who have provided me with your comments. Now, a lot of you asked why I didn't do the comparison between the iPad Pro and the Surface Pro. And the answer is I just didn't have one at the time. But now I'm attending TechDays Sweden, a conference for technology people. And now I'm going to take notes on the Surface Pro. So this is the new Surface Pro. I've been using the Surface Pro for years. I've had the Surface Pro 2, the Surface Pro 4. Now you would think that the one following Surface Pro 4 would be Surface Pro 5, but it's actually not. Microsoft dropped the version number, so this is just called Surface Pro. If you get a bit confused about which version you have, you can just open the kickstand and there's a number here showing which version you have. So just Google that number and you'll figure it out. So today I'm going to take notes on the Surface Pro. Microsoft say that this version has a much better battery life than the previous one, and that the performance is better, and that it has a more rounded shape and it's more comfortable to hold. Today I'm going to use OneNote and I'm going to put it to the test. So let's see. The Surface Pro has the keyboard as part of the cover, a so-called type cover. You can either have the keyboard flat on the table, similar to a traditional laptop, or you can fold it up if you want to have more of a tilt, which I actually prefer. The tilt also makes it easier if you want to type with the device in your lap. The type cover has really improved since it was first introduced. But if you ask me, I still prefer the solid keyboard that you have on the Surface Book. Unlike with the Surface Book, where you can only tilt the screen back slightly, the Surface Pro enables you to tilt the screen really far down. This is great if you're typing and you just want to add some handwritten notes on the screen. On the Surface Book, you can detach the screen from the keyboard and then attach it again facing the other way. This way, you can use the Surface Book in so-called studio mode, which is great for drawing or handwriting. The downside is that then you can't easily use the keyboard. To remove the keyboard from the Surface Pro is much easier. You don't have to press any button, you just remove the keyboard. The Surface Pro, just like the Surface Book, is a full-fledged Windows PC. This means that you can select between running the more basic OneNote app that's available in the Microsoft Store, or the rich desktop version of OneNote, currently OneNote 2016. Both of these apps are free to download. For basic note-taking, I would advise you to use the OneNote app. Here you can easily switch between various pens and colors and thickness of pen. You can use the lasso tool to circle things and then move them around. You have the insert and remove space tool, which enables you to add or remove space in your page as needed. The insert and remove space tool is not available in the iPad Pro, which makes rearranging your notes very tricky. In the OneNote app on Surface devices, you can easily insert pictures by clicking Insert, Pictures, and then From Camera. You don't have this option in the rich desktop version of OneNote. Unfortunately, the photo quality using OneNote on the Surface devices is not very good, especially at events like this where the lighting isn't very good. You have more options when taking photos using the OneNote app on the iPad Pro. Here you can zoom, focus, and crop your images before inserting them into OneNote. The quality of the images is also much better. What I like about using OneNote on the Surface devices is that you can use the pen and the eraser without having to worry about switching tabs like you do if you're using the OneNote app on the iPad. You can also click the magnetic button on the Surface Pen to start the lasso tool to select items in your notes. Also, the pen just works without you having to pair it with your Surface device. If you do pair it, however, you get even more functionality out of the pen. For instance, you can launch an app by clicking the top of the pen. If I press the top of the pen once, It launches the rich desktop version of OneNote. And if I press twice, it launches the OneNote app. There are even more things you can do with the settings of the pen to improve the writing experience, but I won't go into details here. If you want to know more about digital note-taking, then don't miss my session at the upcoming OneNote conference that's airing in November. So, what's the verdict then? Well, as you can see, it's the end of the conference, and I've been using the Surface Pro all day. And the battery has lasted, and I haven't had to recharge it once. Now, I haven't compared it side by side with the iPad Pro, so I don't know which battery life is longer, but it doesn't really matter since I can get through the day using the Surface Pro. In terms of note-taking, you have much more options when you're using OneNote on the Surface Pro. You can insert and remove space. You can easily write and then just erase with the back of the pen. Also, you don't have to recharge the battery of the pen like you do on the iPad. Overall, the Surface Pro wins in all categories except one, which is actually very important when you're taking notes at a conference like this one, and that is the camera. So the camera on the Surface Pro just doesn't give you the high quality pictures that you do on the iPad. Now you can work around this by taking pictures with your mobile phone and then inserting them into your notes, but it comes a bit clumsy. So what should you choose? Well, what I would say is that if you have a laptop that you're happy with, but you want a device that you can take handwritten notes with, then go for the iPad Pro. But if you're looking for a new device that you can use as your laptop as well as your writing device, then definitely Surface Pro. If you're interested in digital note-taking, don't miss my upcoming session in the OneNote conference that's airing in November called From Pen and Paper to Digital Note-Taking Experts. Also, keep a lookout for my blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, that's airing soon. My name is Ulrika Hedlund. Thank you for watching.